1, 2, 3, 4, McCrackenatMidnight!
From Bassturd!
You're watching the show! Crap!
Show!
McCrackenatMidnight! From the Bassturd!
You're watching the show!
Show!
It just never works when we don't have the ukulele.
Show!
Hey everybody! Welcome to McCrackenatMidnight with Brian the Bassturd! It's Monday.
Don't worry about it, Sam. Just fucking throw it.
It's Monday again.
Actually throw it.
And we're here doing it in front of you. It's fine.
Look, this old spot of paint on my t-shirt is right on my belly button.
Yeah? Wait.
You know what happened today to
me? Move your finger. We can't see it on the camera.
My belly button, I was moving
Exploded!
I was moving kind of. I was moving a flight case, and the little friggin' metal like tab that the lock is supposed to go through. I was lifting it and it got caught in my belly button, like through my shirt, and like pulled the skin, and then my belly button's still sore.
Ew.
Yeah, it sucked.
That's gross.
How you doing, everybody out there? We kind of were down to the wire tonight because Melodigo was practicing down here, which we're all about.
Those jerks.
Yeah, but
they shouldn't practice.
Yeah.
Man, I drank my Dr. Pepper really fast.
You know, we used to play with a ukulele and a little Casio keyboard. I tried that for a while, but it was too hipster. It's hipster enough just with the ukulele, but if you take, like, the second most hipster instrument and put the first most on top of it, it's like...
Dr. Pepper!
That's what it's like. Nice shot.
Anyway,
so, we're going to jump into the news because we got some cool stuff we want to talk about.
We have a very nice list tonight of things.
We totally forgot.
In any case, so we got a lot of news tonight. We got some movie news coming on later.
Mm-hmm.
But right now, we got some regular news. Actually, I don't know how much news I have, to be completely honest.
I got a couple things to
talk. Go for it. You get started.
It's loose if it's... What I have is loosely... news. You know what? I'm actually going to pull this up on Geekology. There was an article today that, and I just got to look up his name. The guy who played the Green Ranger, the original Green Ranger, that is. His name was, and you'll know any second, Jason David Frank. Jason David Frank was the original Green Ranger and Power Rangers, and he apparently, on top of being a great actor, he was actually a martial artist, as all the actors on that show were, and he's now a mixed martial arts fighter exposition. You know, I'm not sure exactly what being a mixed martial artist really means, like, as a career, but he's a mixed martial artist.
I mean, it's career,
and
so
he recently
get on him. I don't have a career.
Set the record for most... planks of wood karate chopped in half while skydiving.
Awesome!
The record is 7. And this is great, but what really interests me is that in the article it says that the previous record was 5.
Wait, so he did 7?
So he wasn't even the first. It's not like he had this
raising
crazy
the bar from 5 to 7.
It's not like he had this crazy idea. I don't know if there's like a thing that people do. Or what? Or maybe he held the previous record also? Or maybe it's just him and one other guy, and now that guy's gotta go get 8? Whatever, just the idea of a Power Ranger falling through the air.
Yeah, my question is,
I'm just glad that this happens on this Earth.
I know that a skydive isn't very, you know, it's not a super long time from jumping out of the plane to hitting the parachute. But 7 doesn't seem like very many.
Well, you think,
to be completely honest.
Think about it.
And is it, like, is it because of wind resistance? Is it because of, like, I don't even, like, to have to, like, swing twice as hard to get through the air, and he's cutting through the air,
yeah,
too.
Well, think about it. Think about it. You got to jump out of the plane. First of all, the whole like last leg of the fall, you got your parachute, and then you need to be able to have enough time to prepare, open your parachute, be prepared for
problems. I mean, that's just pulling a cord,
I mean, but you got to, you know, you don't want to fuck up, especially if you're distracted by other stuff. You really need some wiggle room there. Then also you need to be able to get out of the plane, get away from the plane. Then the guy who's holding the planks of wood, because there's a picture of it here, guy holds them for him. The guy holding the planks of wood needs to get over to him. They need to position themselves, pull the wood out, and then it probably is hard. He's got to line up his shot hard, you know?
It's, well, that's what I'm saying. I mean, like,
you're actually, like, karate chopping planks in half in midair. Like,
well,
that's
no, I mean, like, you see videos of these of guys doing these things. They do, like, 10 in 5 seconds, you know what I mean? They just, like, go from one to the other, you know what I mean? So I feel like...
they're not falling out of the plane.
Okay, but I'm saying, despite all those things, I still feel that's a little bit slow. I'm not saying I could do better. Saying I could do better. I'm just saying he should try a little bit harder next time he jumps out of an airplane.
The only news I come up with for the week is Power Ranger karate chops planks of wood in midair falling out of an airplane, and you still manage to be like,
that's awesome. That is awesome in its own right. Clearly, that is a tremendous feat that I nor anyone I actually know could accomplish in their lifetime, but I just wish it was like 50. You know what I mean? Right, I just wish it was a little.
Hopefully,
that's all I'm saying. I'd still give him a big kiss when he landed. But you know, I'd just be like, I'd kiss him, and then I'd be like, seven. Anyway,
That's. Maybe the other Zach.
The Red Ranger?
He was the Black Ranger.
Oh, who was the Red Ranger?
I don't remember. But Zach was my favorite.
Okay. I believe you then.
And I think maybe Zach will get 8 next time and you'll feel a little bit better about yourself. Moving on.
I'll feel a little bit better about society when that happens, you know, about the direction the world is going. In other news, this is, you know,
turn
whatever.
Turn a little bit. It looks really bad.
Turn you. It's because we're shouting. It's fine. It's normal. Okay. In other news, here, let me pull up the thing. Hang on 1 second. Get that out of here. In other news, this guy, there's a man going by the name of, what's his name? Bourgeois Banana. it was inspired by Django Unchained and recreated the plantation in The Sims 3 with slaves.
I used to make castles that would have like fuckers in the dungeon, and there would be like a torture master who lived down in the basement, and then like some poor guy who just got beat on and harassed all day.
Yeah,
but this is a new level.
Yeah,
actually,
this guy, he was inspired by Django Unchained, so he recreated the plantation and complete with. So the house itself looks pretty cool. I mean, he did a good job like making a neat house, you know, period era appropriate house. Wait, I gotta sneeze. Anyway. Excuse me. But then we get to the slaves. And it's just straight up slaves working in the fields. There's the, you know, house people. And there they all are!
Oh, God, man.
And this guy is just running a nice little slave community in...
I like the kid's jacket. It's really, really cool.
Actually, yeah, that is pretty good. Yeah, I mean, like, besides it being, you know, this is kind of weird because this dude's, like, created a slave plantation in The Sims. Like, he's got some sweet, like, texture packs and, like, and stuff like that.
I mean, he did it up.
Yeah, he made it, like, really real.
Go big or go home, I guess.
Yeah, seriously.
There's a lot of racially charged things in tonight's show, aren't there?
There are. Actually, let's go on to that next.
Yeah, we should have done it last week. We should have done all the, like, weird, kind of all maybe racist stuff for Martin Luther King Day, I think.
Mr. Mark Schwaller, our political and environmental correspondent,
posted this
video on Facebook earlier. And first, we're just going to play the video, and you can watch it. And then we'll talk about it a little bit, but it's hilarious. Just watch this.
Yeah. So you think you look pretty good wearing your pants like that, don't you? Underwear exposed, hip-hop style. Well, there's something you may not know. You can be fined up to $300, be placed in a state prison for up to 3 years, or be placed in a county jail for up to 2 years. You still think it's cool? It's the law. Pull up your pants. Respect yourself.
This message brought to you by the Black Mental Health Alliance of Massachusetts.
Yeah. So, this is a Boston area thing that's been...
That was specifically Boston. Boston?
Yeah, it's a Boston advertisement that's been...
that was made in 1994.
Yeah, been airing on the television.
And just aired.
And, but yeah, first of all, Black Mental Health Alliance is putting this together. And I really don't want to get into this because, for the same reason we avoid politics, because often it gets aggravating or depressing or whatever. But let's just come out and say it real quick. I don't like how racist this ad is.
Yeah.
Internal racism is, like, the thing that I dislike the most. I just...
It's worse than external racism it really in some is. Ways.
Yeah, wait, are white people allowed to sag their pants? That's exactly right. Like, I mean, like, seriously, this is an ad saying, hey, we're black, and hey, black people, stop making us look so bad. Like,
which is noble, but, I mean, I grew up with lots of friggin' douchey white dudes with their pants, with their ass hanging out.
Also, everyone should be able to dress the way they want. I mean, I honestly, like, that's not that
Take
big
your
deal.
Pants off
yeah, seriously.
In public.
I mean, they're wearing shorts underneath anyway.
Yeah, they weren't even...
Anyway, but despite all that, what a hilarious advertisement. Like, what? You could
that's,
be charged...
Is that actually on TV?
I think so, yeah. It's they got the little ad
Has
at the
anyone
end.
Ever gone to prison for having...
Everyone should wear thongs made of glass. Oh, that'd be uncomfortable. Anyway, yeah, you can be charged up to $300 or, like, 3 years in prison.
I'm sure that's happened, like, a whole bunch of times.
You're gonna go to prison, and they don't even cite a specific law. They just say, it's the law. Like, don't pull your pants down. Like, it's just... I mean, I can assume some laws, but it's just hilarious. I don't know. It's stupid. Anyway, moving on from that.
I like how it's also
hip-hop style.
Hip-hop style.
Hip-hop style.
I'm gonna. I get up in the morning. And I was
you
like,
"Yo, Marky Mark spun some hip hop too." All right,
I'm gonna wear my pants hip hop style today.
Yeah, I actually have a day marked off on the calendar. Yeah. Hip hop day. Anyway,
I want to before I forget, I want to give a quick shout out to my friend and pal, Ainsley Henderson, who I met up at Ottawa this year, and his short, which is his first short that he's ever really gone out in the world with, it won the student award and some other award at Ottawa, and now, I just found out today, it's up for an Annie, which is, I guess, like, the animation,
Is this dude?
Yeah, that dude. So, like, the animation, thing. What's it called? Like Oscars, like the animation Oscars.
Like short film at the Oscars?
Yeah. No. It's own awards thing. But
That's him.
It's they're big time. I don't know much about them honestly, but I'm just happy, you know, cuz it was awesome. Awesome film and really really unbelievably nice guy and you know, hopefully our paths will cross again out there in the small world that is animation.
Yeah.
If I'm ever in Scotland showing a movie, we're going to party together. Anyway, I just want to get that out of the way. And
Good job, Ainsley!
I'm going to look more up on the Annies and talk more about them sooner because I just found out that they existed today. And I'm going to look them up and learn more about it. I think you have stuff about cartoons, though, don't you, Sam? Also, too.
I do.
Cartoons.
I have some stuff about cartoons.
We have some not-so-good news about cartoons.
I mean,
if I'm
interesting.
Know what's about to
happen. It's not terrible news. It's just very interesting news. I can't say it's bad news because it's new. It's news for the future. It's not, like, things we know about now. What are you doing?
I want this blanket.
It's a towel, dude.
Cool. No, it's a blanket. It's a fleece blanket.
Looks like a towel. Anyway, so have I put? Yeah, we're gonna talk about that later.
Yeah, we'll get to it.
And we're gonna talk about that. the new Star Wars is going to be a cartoon. No. Actually, let's start with... No, we'll get to that.
We'll get to that.
Okay, we got a whole string of television and film-related
things.
Lots of good stuff. Anyway, first of all, Cartoon Network released a bunch of titles that have gotten into green lights into production for Cartoon Network either in the summer or the fall. I don't know when. Besides some disappointing news about certain named characters, of which it doesn't matter.
Yeah, we basically.
Just say Rebecca Sugar, I'm coming for you.
Sam, Rebecca.
Don't worry
Sugar
about it. Don't
spied on Sam McCracken and stole his idea for a character.
Don't worry about it.
The only theory we.
It doesn't matter.
That's what we think.
It doesn't matter.
Right now.
Anyway, they released a whole bunch of names for new cartoons that are going to go on. Coming in soon. First of all, they're expanding their... they have the DC Nation thing Saturday mornings. They're expanding that. Right now, it's Young Justice, which is awesome, and the Green Lantern, which I haven't really watched, but everybody says it's kind of okay. They're expanding that to include...
Superhero, the Green Lantern.
Dude, Green Lantern's awesome.
He's great. I love the Green Lantern, but he never gets quite the right treatment that he deserves.
It's absolutely true. Anyway, yeah. They're expanding that to include Teen Titans Go, which is a... reimagination of the exact same Teen Titans cartoon that was on in the early aughts, which was awesome. Like, that was such a good cartoon. It was great Teen Titans. So they're doing, like, a cuter interpretation of that with all the original cast and everything like that.
It's going to be basically a remake, a cartoonier-looking remake.
It's going to be a cartoonier and more kid-friendly remake, yeah. And then they're also making a new Batman cartoon, finally. It's been years since the Batman. And they're finally making a new Batman cartoon.
Shit, it has.
I didn't even
think of that.
It's going to be called Beware the Batman, and it's going to be the first CG animated Batman. Which, what they're doing with Green Lantern, they're making it, they're doing a good job with the Green Lantern in making it not look like realistic CG. They're making it look really cartoony, but not like shitty like Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles is. Not like terrible and like dropping frames and like heads go through other heads.
But that's the way Teenage Mutant Turtles would need to be.
I mean,
I know. That's the way the original cartoon was.
No, that's true. Anyway,
I didn't notice it until I watched James Rolfe's review of he did like a 3-part TMNT cartoon review, and then when I went back and watched the shows, I started noticing all the shit wrong. It's messed up.
It's hilarious.
There's like see-through stuff and guys' eyes disappearing and voices getting messed up.
Yeah.
That show's a wreck.
And the new one is no different.
So that's good. It's carried into a new era of shittiness.
Why? I hope you're watching right now, and why are you texting me if you're watching right now? You're crazy, and I miss you. So new Batman cartoon. CG animated, kind of exciting. Beware the Batman. It's going to be made by the same guy that created the Teen Titans cartoon and worked on Superman and Batman the Animated series. It's actually probably going to be a pretty good cartoon.
Which was, the Batman the Animated series was my favorite Batman.
By the way,
animated
I just downloaded
series.
All of it.
Oh, so good. The Clayface episode.
I know. Where he's in the press. I know. Anyway, so that's the new thing. And the cool part about this is they're saying they're going to have lots of Batman villains that are lesser known and haven't made appearances in the TV show, namely Professor Pig, which
cool.
would be pretty cool.
Never even heard of Professor Pig.
It's okay. He's a cool, dude. Anyway, one of the big things... That is the interesting / slightly worried some news, is that another CG show that they're making is a Powerpuff Girls remake.
Show them. Now...
So this image that we're going to look at here is... We're not really sure what this is. This is like an initial release of what they think it's going to look like. It seems it's going to be CG, so it's not going to look exactly like this. I don't know what this is, even. Like, I don't know what's going on over here. Oh, they can't see my... Oh, yeah, they can. I don't know what's going on over here. I don't know what's going on with Bubble's eyes and her bangs there.
Yeah, I mean, the original design... had so much style and was so much like a rip on standard
straight
style.
Up Craig McCracken, man.
It was great. And now going into this and knowing that Lauren Faust's last show was a giant, filthy, disgusting fart color, Friendship is Magic.
Oh, oh right. Oh, yeah.
Which no, I sorry, tried. Sorry. I like Lauren Faust, or I did previously in my life, and I was like, I really want to like this show, because so many people do, and no, it's awful. And it's badly written, and it looks like it came, like I ate a box of Skittles and then vomited.
Yeah.
And then it was out
anyway,
of focus.
So like Powerpuff Girls.
So I really don't want that to happen.
Well, Lauren Faust probably isn't going to be working on
well,
it.
Well, now, they what was that picture of the two
that's
of them?
Something else. That's something else? That's something different that I'm going to talk about in a second.
I was confused
because
there
was
a picture of...
Everything will become clear.
Okay.
Anyway, the Powerpuff Girls is actually going to be a special that they're doing. It doesn't appear to be a series, but it's going to be like a special, maybe a short series or something like that. The original cast is going to be there. All the lovely ladies doing their voices, which is awesome.
That's good.
That's
yeah,
a good thing. But it's got a whole new production team. McCracken is not on it at all, which is a good thing, because I don't want him to be associated with this and have his image sullied in my mind.
He's too good for it.
But he is working on a new project for Disney, which is what that picture was that you saw.
Oh, and
so,
is Miss Faust on it as well?
I mean, I would assume that she is, almost. Boo, tell me correct. No, you're wrong. Okay. Agreed. Okay, whatever. Anyway, so yeah, we have a new show. We have a preview. For the new show. We haven't watched it yet either, so we're going to watch it right now, too. And then we'll talk about it. Ready?
Yep.
So, that's that.
Yeah.
Looks like classic Craig McCracken.
That looks like just classic cartoons in general.
Yeah.
Looks like totally classic. That looks awesome.
I
wish it wasn't fucking taped out of a theater.
Yeah. Yeah, that's clearly just a tape from some random screener.
But yeah, that looks really, really
yeah,
good.
Yeah, Lauren Faust, co-producer.
Cool.
It's called Wander Over Yonder. That's it. It's going to be on the Disney Channel.
Boo-hoo, yeah.
That's all that I appear to know. So that's cool. I love it when Craig McCracken makes things.
Mm-hmm.
Also, he's got my last name, and distantly I am related to him, so I'm very happy.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I'll call him up and be like, hey, we're in some way cousins. Give me a job.
That'll work. That'll work. I'm sure he'll be like, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, totally. Anyway, it does look like Rocky and Bullwinkle a little bit, but that's, I think, just the style.
And is that a problem? Are you saying...
Yeah, Rocky and Bullwinkle's the best.
It's fucking awesome.
Anyway, so yeah.
Anyway,
so that's all that. That's all the cartoon news going on and all the TV news.
I have a couple things that are kind of video game based. First of all, yes, Age of Empires 2. It was so good that they made Age of Mythology. And they made Age of Empires 3, since Age of Empires 2 came out in late 90s.
Yeah.
And,
Age of Empires 2 is
better. It's so good that they're still making downloadable content for it.
Someone is.
Someone is. Not the original. And I honestly can't never remember who made what studio produced Age of Empires. But, regardless, This is, there was, first of all, there was the Star Wars edition that came out a few years ago, which was like a whole, a mod that was like a whole nother game, but uses the same, basically, engine, or model, palette. But now it's an expansion pack. Age of Empires 2 Forgotten Empires. There's a couple new,
You gotta go to game. Features.
Features.
Just click. Yeah, click on features.
Yeah, basically, it introduces some new playable empires, races, whatever civilizations, whatever they're called in this particular game. You 50 plus population limit. That's huge.
That's awesome.
250 population.
Yeah, that's gigantic. Yes.
9 new units, 30 new technologies, 1 new building, 11 new maps, 2 new architecture sets, 20 new scenario editor objects. Which the map editor, or scenario editor as they call it, in Age of Empires 2 was awesome, and really easy to use, but also really, really thorough. New campaigns, it says here, and higher resolution.
Ooh, team random option.
Team random. Ooh, that's new. Yeah.
Improved networking.
Windowed
that nice.
Mood, that's cool.
Various bug fixes? Yeah, I'm all over various bug fixes.
Various bug fixes are good. I hope it doesn't get rid of the purple water glitch that happens when that was the best. I would miss that if they got rid of that. But anyway, I see a waterfall.
Yeah, I like waterfalls.
Up here in the graphics.
Water barriers. Sweet.
Yeah, it's gonna be awesome. And it came out a couple days ago. I can't play it yet because I have a Mac, and it's only
I know. I just downloaded. Speaking of most stolen game of all time, I just got Age of Empires 2 for Mac. It downloaded in literally 10 minutes. That plus Age of whatever it is, Conquers. But yeah, this is out only for Windows right now, which sucks a lot.
Hopefully that is temporary.
Hopefully in the next month someone will port it to Mac.
Yeah. I usually play it on my partition anyway. So next time I go to a LAN fest, it will get passed to me and I'll install it.
Yeah.
Now, does this work in conjunction?
You can just download it right here, man.
I could do that.
It's just free.
I'm wondering if it works in conjunction with the Conquerors. It must.
I'm sure it does. I'm sure it does, because I would be shocked. Ooh, Slavs.
Oh, by the way, Italians,
Incas, yeah.
Italians, Indians, Slavs, Magyars.
Magyars.
What?
Magyars?
Whatever, whoever those guys are. And Incas. I don't know what the Incas are going to have that the Mayans and the Aztecs don't already suck at. But,
we got, this person says you guys should have a LAN fest.
We should, and we will. We had one here at the Monkey Palace at one point, and it was pretty fun. We can't very well do one at our apartment.
Sadly, no.
No, that would not be
our internet's better, though.
Our internet's better.
I mean, we could. Yeah. There just wouldn't be a lot of room for people. We could do
it. Honestly, there wasn't a lot of room for people down here.
Yeah. Anyway, that's very cool. Very exciting news.
Yeah, that's great. This is like one of my favorite games ever.
Well, Brian's pulling up his next news thing.
My personal culture between me and my friends is widely based on this. So this is huge, huge, huge news for us.
I just want to mention real quick, the company iRobot, which makes the Roombas, has created a 3D printer attached to a robot. So basically it's a 3D printer that can govern itself and do all the things that a 3D printer usually needs human hands to do. Which basically means, you know, when a 3D printer prints things, it prints pieces and then it's got, plastic bits and, metal bits all over it that it need to be, cut off in order to be put together and stuff like that. But they attached a robot to this one, so basically this is, an autonomous robot creating robot. This thing, you plug matter into this, and it makes something and then puts that thing together. So it can literally build other robots. This robot can build other robots.
I don't know if it can build shit that complicated.
Well, but it will be. I'd what?
you hit a nerve or something, and then I need my computer, and then I almost need my drink over.
Anyway, I can't do it now, but eventually, like, this is
Sam
what
is
this is
terrified of robots.
I'm not terrified of robots. I'm terrified that humanity is creating robots in a haphazard and unintelligent way. I mean, yeah, we're already basing things off the three laws of robot, laws of robotics.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm just afraid that we're trying too hard. Eventually, they're just gonna turn back on us. And this is exactly what this is. This is a self-replicating robot.
Why? But
this is a self-replicating robot, Brian.
Here's the argument I always give you, and you never quite get it. But you have a robot. Why does it revolt? What does it want?
I'm not saying it revolts.
Does it want
money? No. You're misunderstanding me. I'm not saying it revolts. And no, hang on. Just to be clear, it's not Skynet, because Skynet was an artificial intelligence plugged into our defense network. Very, very different from self-replicating robots. Eventually, down the line, Skynet was like, hey, let's start making...
Skynet had self-replicating robots. It wasn't a self-replicating robot.
Yeah, this
itself.
Is just straight up... this is kind of like Skynet, but this is like Sarah Connor Chronicles, gotta kill that robot so Skynet can't use it later on kind of thing. Yes, build sentient robots that... but robots, it's not so much that they are going to revolt. It's just that we are giving them the opportunity to revolt. You know what I mean? It's like it's exactly the same as people often don't consider, building robots as playing God, because they aren't, sentient life forms. They're not,
mm-hmm.
they're not self-aware, you know what I mean? But if we keep advancing them like we do, eventually, computers are built to learn. Computers learn more and more now. Just computers that we have are learning more and more. Siri calls me butthead. I can just tell Siri to call me butthead. Eventually this robot, this self-replicating robot, is going to be like, wow, I could just make a billion of me, and then we could make a billion more of me. It's like that episode of Futurama where Bender is eating all the metal in the world and just making more of himself.
It was awesome.
He eats the matter, and then he makes two of himself when he eats the matter. And then they just keep doing that, and then they make the giant Bender. And then giant freaking what's-his-face has to fight him. And it's like, awesome.
Clamps.
Clamps! No, Zoidberg.
Zoidberg
has to fight. You're thinking
him.
Of the episode where Clamps fights Zoidberg on the moon.
Is that what happened?
When Bender is the moon hillbilly. Clamps!
I can't remember.
Anyway, robots. We all just need to be cautious. Exercise some serious caution.
Just
here.
In general, not even while building robots.
Yeah, I mean, just in general, sure, but especially when building robots. Moving on.
News on the war for Aaron Schwartz. Is it Schwartz?
It's Schwartz.
It is Schwartz. It's just SW. Anonymous, and I'm reading this off an article of someone who is basically trashing all over Anonymous. Which is, granted, easy to do, but I wouldn't.
It's because you adore Anonymous.
They have goofinesses that they're guilty of, but they're pretty awesome when you get down to it. Website of US www.ussc.gov, which is
Sentencing Commission.
It's the Sentencing Commission of the federal government. I guess the judges and that stuff. They hacked their website, and apparently the first one was standard anonymous hack. The website goes straight to a video of anonymous stuff, and then saying how
anonymous cool, people saying anonymous things.
How cool Aaron Schwartz was, and
yeah.
How much the government sucks, and how information wants to be free. Yada yada yada. All good things, but we've heard it before. Then they took it down. They fixed it because they fix these things really quickly. But
it's
then
like smart people working there or something.
Yeah, but then they hacked it again on Sunday.
Boom.
And that time, they put up a playable game of Asteroids with some modifications. Apparently, you could summon a Nyan Cat to fire, shoot across the board, and wipe stuff out. So that is way more my style.
Yeah.
Of rebellion, replacing government websites with video games. Video games that use internet tropes. That's what information. That's the essence of the internet to me. Just like replace order.
Typing in the Konami code.
Yeah, just replacing order with absurdity. That is beyond. That is my religion, essentially. Especially in data form. So that really really touches me deeply, and I'm so excited that they did this. Unfortunately, it's gone now. I'm sure. I mean, not that I've checked, but why would I even, you know, bother looking?
The website's not even coming up now.
Oh.
Just the website's down. It's not even on. Which sucks, because I was going to freaking type some up and down and play some
Nyansteroids. Get my WASD on.
Get my cat on.
But anyway, at least they fucked the government website up pretty badly enough that it's still down.
I mean, it's the U.S. Prohibition Court of the District of Eastern Michigan. It's not like... It's kind of like,
it's
okay.
It's something, you know? You got to start somewhere.
Yeah. Man, I love pizza too, you streamer 558951. Pizza is like the best thing ever. I was having a conversation at work today. I work at a restaurant. And we were all at Panera eating some food. We're talking about how good free food is and how much better it tastes and stuff like that. And I was like, I interjected and I was like, you know what, guys? Free food's really good, but I think I'd take paying for pizza over free food any day. Because paying for pizza is just the best thing in the world. Because you get the delicious taste of pizza.
Wait.
And you get to contribute to more pizza.
Did I call him Rick Schwartz? Is that what happened?
No, that person said Rick Schwartz.
No, okay, yeah, sorry. I thought, no, he's not Rick Schwartz.
But back to pizza. Schwartz. I think pizza's the best thing. And Brian, I have to ask you this question. Would you rather get, like, okay cold pizza out of the trash or pay for bad hot pizza?
Okay cold pizza.
Oh my god, I'd take the hot pizza any day. I'd rather pay for pizza any day of the week. I mean, I'll take free pizza if someone's, like, giving me a regular pizza, but, like, no. I mean, like, free pizza's
like,
great,
like,
but...
really shitty pizza?
No, like bad pizza, like Nemo's.
Oh, that, yeah. I would say I wouldn't consider that bad pizza.
Well, it's, to the general populace, I think it's bad pizza. You take that to New York, people are gonna be like, what the hell is
well,
this?
Well, you take anything to New York, pizza or otherwise, people are gonna fuck with it.
Cold pizza is great and everything, but like free pizza versus hot bad pizza. I'm gonna take the hot bad pizza every time, even if I have to pay for it, because it's like I get to support pizza. You know what I mean? It's like donating to, you know, like you really like blowing up whaling ships and stuff like that. So it's like when you donate to Greenpeace. You
I
know?
Guess yes.
I'm sorry. Donate. In 1995, it's like donating to Greenpeace in 1995.
Yes, support local pizza. Pizza doesn't need support, though. Have you ever seen a pizza place go out of business?
No, I understand.
One I know, and it was right around the corner from here, and it was because they were closed for like 6 months.
But now they're opening it.
No, they closed like permanently. Slice of Pie.
You talking about Slice of Pie? No,
Slice of Pie.
I just saw a sign they were opening again.
Really?
They're opening again.
They like can't make up their minds. Whatever it is, it's not because people aren't going there to buy pizzas, because they're fucking up. Pizza places, you can't, like, if you make pizza... Like, people will buy it.
I agree. It doesn't matter. But I want to... It's not so much that the, you know, the DNC needs my money to run their next, you know, terrible, we're actually trying to be middle-of-the-road Democrats campaign. It's not that they need my money, but if I'm giving them my money, it's because I really, really want to give them my money. You know what I mean? It's not so much about, like, they need my money. I just want to throw money at them.
Do you give the DNC money, Sam?
No, I'm just using that as an example that perhaps other people can relate to. Maybe people that don't eat pizza as much as we do.
Radio.
That's
radio.
Radio. That's pretty. Yeah. Yeah. It's not so much that like I think that they're not going to. No.
WNBR.
Yeah. WNBR.
The best.
WNBR is awesome. You know, I donated to them. They don't really need the money. I mean, they do, but like. They'll figure something
out. Dude, it's called radio. They don't need the fucking
money.
Okay,
well, then NPR, like, you know, freaking WGBH or whatever it is. Like, you know, they don't really need the money. Like, public broadcast, like, national public radio, they're going to do okay no matter what because thousands and thousands and thousands of people are giving them money. But, like, I really like Brian Hungry Panda, so I'm going to throw my money at them anyway. It's exactly the same. You know, I just love pizza. And I love it when Garrison Keillor feeds me pizza. Talking about Lake Wobegon.
I just
wanted to put pizza in my mouth.
I love Garrison. Just sit there, not move my arms, and like, ah.
He's just
telling stories.
Yeah.
And putting pizza in my mouth.
Yeah, I think I support pizza more than any other cause. Well said, Ustreamer 2181.
I probably do too.
It's just the best cause in the universe. Save the whales. Save the moon.
Kill Whitey.
And eat pizza. Done.
That's my new slogan, I think. Kill Whitey, eat
kill
pizza.
Kill Whitey, eat pizza. So we're going to move on to something really big now.
Big.
The big thing that we're going to talk about tonight.
Which we have 20 minutes left in the show, and I think we can
follow up with this. Yeah, we can. First of all, let me just say, before we get to the big news, the Disney was going to turn the Star Wars prequels into 3D. They're going to make them 3D, which is pointless, because, like, nobody likes 3D anyway. Like, they're just doing it so people will go see the movies again in a new way. You know, that's all they were doing. But then
they
were like...
the original Star Wars.
No, the prequels.
Yeah.
They were going to turn them into 3D and re-release them. And then they were like, wait a minute, why are we doing that? We should just put all our money to the new trilogy. Like, that's what we're actually going to do.
Who's going to be like, oh, let's go... I saw Phantom Menace 4 times in the theater.
Yeah.
3 times too many.
Yeah.
I was lying to myself so hard.
Yeah.
And I was like, why would I want to go see it a 5th time?
Yeah.
And beat my record. Match my record with Lord of the Rings.
Yeah, yeah.
No. No one wants to see that fucking movie.
But it's not so much that. It's that they said, we're not going to do 3D, and instead we're just going to focus all our time and money on the new 3 movies. Which is awesome. Like, good job, Disney. You know, and I want to say, you know, because of that, of course we're going to get 3D versions eventually of everything. Like, that's inevitable. But with this, like, push towards creating the new 3 movies instead of going back and re-releasing the old movies in 3D, maybe this is the first sign that Disney isn't going to just, like, this may be the first sign that we're going to have Star Wars forever, basically. That Disney's just going to keep putting out Star Wars films. Which, honestly, they're going to get really bad eventually. Like... no doubt they're probably going to suck eventually because it's going to become a parody of itself. But I don't even care.
James Bond became shitty and then got good again.
That's true. That's absolutely true.
And then got shitty again and then got good again.
Yeah.
And then got shitty again and then got good again.
Yeah, like movie to movie, of course. But
yeah, I got really tight in the end there.
Yeah. But, I forgot. I'll talk about that next week. So, yeah, that's cool. You know, just like, we're going to get Star Wars for a really long time. Which is really sweet, because it's the best thing ever.
These are cold.
I'm sorry. But the really big news is that we finally have a director for Star Wars. And his name is... J.J. Abrams is his name. J.J. Abrams of Lost and Alias and, you know, what was that other show? Alcatraz and then Star Trek.
Which he already put Star Wars characters in.
He already... C-3PO and R2-D2 is already in it.
Yeah.
Anyway, J.J. Abrams is directing the new Star Wars movie.
Mission Impossible 3, too. But
Mission Impossible
But who 3. Gives a shit?
No, Mission Impossible 4.
Whatever.
The new one, which apparently was cool, and I might watch that tonight when I get home, because it's on Netflix now. Anyway,
this is, in case you can't tell, good news.
This is good news!
J.J. Abrams is not Joss Whedon, which is who me and Sam wanted to direct the new Star Wars movie.
Oh, yeah, Kill Whitey, Eat Pizza is Do the Right Thing. Well said. You're right.
What?
The movie Kill Whitey, Eat Pizza is Do the Right Thing. That's the movie
I've never seen Do the Right Thing.
You ever seen Do the Right Thing?
No.
All right, we'll talk about that later.
Is it a movie about black militants who open a pizza place?
No, it's a movie about... No.
That movie would be awesome.
No, not quite, but it's you'll like it a lot when you see it. Anyway, J.J. Abrams, go on.
I was just saying, it's really cool. It's not epically, unbelievably amazing, but like I really...
It's not Joss Whedon.
It's not Joss Whedon, and that's all it's not.
Yeah.
it's really as well as I could have possibly. Like, it's like, they came out and I was like, wow. And that's when I meant that they're really giving the series the attention that it deserves.
Yes, yeah,
they're giving
it.
I knew when they said this, it's like, they're, and not just because J.J. Abrams is going to be do a good job, but Disney, as a production company, that means, that's a sign that they are going to continue
try
to make the right decisions.
Yeah.
That they're really giving it the proper treatment.
Yeah. So, J.J. Abrams is good for a number of reasons. First of all, everybody likes Alias. Everybody likes Lost. Everybody likes just him in general. He's kind of just a cool dude. And he has proven himself greatly with rebooting the original Star Trek, which is, like, a huge thing. Star Trek, which has been around for a very large number of years, he took it and gave it a fresh new face and a whole new story, like, rebooted it, like, literally, so he wasn't just retconning everything. And it's really good.
Fucking back.
And it's a huge deal. Here, you want to use the back? You want to use the back pillow?
Yeah.
I've been sitting on the back pillow this whole time. Feels really good. Anyway, yeah, he's totally proven himself with that. He's proven himself with science fiction, of course. Oh, and Fringe. That's the other awesome thing.
Oh, yeah, of course.
He's absolutely proven himself with science fiction. I mean, between all the television shows he's done and then Star Trek.
Star Wars is only vaguely science fiction when you get down to it. You know, not in the same way that his other science fiction.
No, of course. But like, what I mean by science fiction in this case is space opera. Because Star Trek is a space opera. And though he's made it more action-y, that's probably a good thing for Star Wars.
Yeah,
you
don't want techno-babble and politics in Star Wars.
No.
Because then you get Episode One.
Bam! I mean, I want the politics in Star Wars. And no doubt we're going to get it, because let's just, real quick, you know, if we're doing, you know, soon after the, you know, the battle at Endor.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be reforming the Galactic Senate and, like, or, like, you know, Luke trying to rebuild the Jedi Temple and, like, running into problems with the Galactic Senate or some junk like that.
Is there any talk of them getting Mark Hamill back to play old Luke? Because he looks weird.
I don't know. I honestly don't know.
He aged poorly into his plastic surgery. He looks kind of like a Ken doll with human eyes.
I'm okay with that, man. He'd play an awesome old Luke now.
Yeah.
He'd be awesome as old Luke. He looks like a dirty old Jedi. He looks like a, like, serious Jedi. You know, we're still in talks to get, you know, they're still in talks to get,
we're making decisions right now.
Yes! They're in talks to get Harrison Ford back to play old Han Solo, which
See,
I'm okay with.
Everything, everyone's the perfect age now. Like, those movies came out, what, almost 30-ish years ago?
Yeah.
That's a good, about the, that's a little less than the time between the two current series, or a little more, rather.
A little more, yeah.
Yeah.
Everybody's the right age for it to be, well, I mean, kind of, everybody's the right age for it to be Chewbacca's about to die. That's where we're at.
Yeah.
I mean, they've got kids. You know, Luke is married Mara Jade.
Carrie Fisher's still hot.
Carrie Fisher's still hot.
She's hotter than she was when she was young.
Well,
yeah, she is.
I don't know about that at all.
Did you see friggin' Fanboys? Whatever. Don't worry about it.
Anyway, but yeah, they've got kids and stuff like that now, and the new Jedi Academy is up and running. And
What about Super 8? It was a movie.
It was J.J. Abrams.
Oh, J.J. Abrams directed that. Really?
I don't know.
It didn't. If he was involved with that, I'd say Super 8 didn't totally suck. It was cool. It had its problems. It kind of sucked.
I still haven't seen it.
It's worth a watch. You watch it once and you're like, and then you kind of like move on, and that's like, you know. What'd you think of Super 8? Ustreamer 558951. I might be cutting it too much slack because I haven't seen it in a long time, but I had problems with it, but I didn't like puke or anything during it. So you liked it,
yeah.
Yeah. It was cool. I'll give it that. It was like, I walked out of that movie and I was like, yeah, sure. Yeah. I almost would have just rather watched a movie about a bunch of teenagers, like, making a fucking zombie movie and not had an alien show up, yeah. Honestly, is how I felt about it.
That would be boring for everybody else, though, Brian.
Yeah, I guess.
Anyway, so back to Star Wars. J.J. Abrams directing Star Wars. Really, really awesome.
Mm-hmm.
A very big deal. That's going to be really cool. Hopefully he'll bring in Damon Lindelof a little bit and like be like, hey, man, let's bring some and Ron Moore, get Ron Moore in there and be like, hey, how do you do, let's put some Battlestar Galactica in here, you know? Let's get some space battles, some really good space battles in here, mm-hmm. or something. Because, honestly, that's one of the coolest parts of Star Wars is that they did space battles really, really good. Like, you know, for all the faults of Return of the Jedi... It's a sweet space battle. It's just good. Even in Lego Star Wars,
Who said Return of the Jedi had faults? Fucking greatest movie ever.
No, you're incorrect.
What was wrong with Return of the Jedi?
Well, the Ewoks were a little silly.
They were.
You know, the writing wasn't as good. Parts of it were pretty predictable.
The whole series is a little cheesy. The whole series is a little cheesy. That's part of whole point.
Yeah, you could argue that, but especially Return of the Jedi.
I guess.
I
don't know. People should say, like, are like, Ewoks, they ruined the thing. And it's like, they didn't
ruin it.
The people get way more upset about Ewoks than they should have. I don't know. I think people misinterpret it as a stab at cuteness, and I don't think they were really even meant... They were cute, but I don't think that was the point.
They weren't meant to be cute. No, not at all. But no, it was definitely the least good of the three. It was. You know it was.
You know it was.
You're just afraid to admit it.
Probably, but in a way it's kind of my favorite just because
that's fine.
The what do you call it? The whole in the Death Star last part is so good and wraps up the series so well. The three of them.
Oh, no. I'm not.
In the throne room is like.
Yeah, yeah, totally.
It's so friggin' solid. Totally. And it's like whatever else is going out, and like even that one part, all the campiness is like just shat out of that.
Yeah, no, totally. Absolutely. Oh, no. I'm not saying that it is a movie at fault. I'm just saying it is the worst of the three.
Okay, I'll give you that.
That scene right there. Is Star Wars. If that scene wasn't as good as it was, those three movies and the prequels wouldn't make any sense. They just wouldn't be as good. The prequels are redeemed by something that happened before the prequels. Honestly. Like, literally, it's like they did that scene in order to make the prequels, like,
well,
be good.
That's actually exactly what they did.
I mean, yeah, but yeah.
Yeah.
I don't want to get it. Anyway, yeah, J.J. Abrams' fake lens flare. I think it's hilarious, and I hope he uses it all the time in Star Wars. I hope it's like, we see, like, you know, I don't even know what character's going to be in there, but we're going to see, like, R2-D2, and he's going to, like, his head's going to swing around, he's going to get his little eye swivel towards the camera, and it's just going to be, like, whoosh, off his little camera eye. Just, like, huge lens flare off of that, you know what I mean? I hope so. That would be hilarious.
You know what would be really good also is now that he put R2-D2 in a Star Trek movie, if he took, like, Beta and had, like, in a battle scene, like, Beta going, woo, like, shooting through space.
Yeah. Do you mean Data?
Data. Beta. Data.
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 That would be pretty good. That, like, because there's the scene in Nemesis where he jumps across the spaceships. Anyway. don't laugh. It's really sad, Brian. Where Data dies.
I'm sorry. I'm picturing my own thing now.
Do you think it? Yeah, there will. No, there wouldn't be force lightning off the. No, there would be. No, there wouldn't be force lightning off the lens flare.
I mean, no lens flare off the force lightning. Yeah, I think there would be. I think there definitely.
It wouldn't really make any sense.
And,
how would there be lens flare off?
And off the lightsabers every time they pop out a lightsaber.
Yeah, that'd be pretty cool.
Off the Death Star blast and the ion cannons and everything.
Oh, man, I can't wait for new Star Wars. Holy crap.
Yeah.
Ugh. Anyway, yes.
Yeah.
Okay, Brian, we haven't really talked about this yet, so right now, don't even think about it. What's your dream Star Wars?
Porno.
Okay, but that already exists.
It probably does. My dream star. I don't know.
For 2015, one movie. What's the dream star?
I can't answer that quickly. I think starting with Chewbacca dying would be really cool.
Yeah.
I think I don't want to see the Empire come back. That's what I don't want. I want it to be about Jedi's trying to reestablish themselves.
Yeah.
Them kind of basically being rejected as something that's old and there's new. And to have almost the, not the new Galactic Senate, or the new Republic, be the bad guy, per se. But I want them to be at odds with the Jedi and have the war part of the Star Wars be a kind of three-way revolt between planets that don't want to join the New Republic, the New Republic, and the Jedi kind of caught in between the two.
Well, that's
and at the same time as they're caught in the middle of this conflict, they're having their own kind of dilemma about the Jedi's identity and the new identity,
the future of the Jedi.
Yeah, and
that's really interesting because that's literally what half of Star Wars Clone Wars is about. The TV show is about there's the separatist planets that there's the Galactic Senate, which is the normal Galactic Senate, all those guys, and then there's the separatists who have their own Senate. Like it's an actual governing body. It's not just a group of evil planets. It's an actual governed body. The separatists, and then there's the non-aligned planets that both of these sides are trying to pull to one side. So that's kind of interesting, a new civil war. Even though that's something that that's kind of just what the Clone Wars was all about. But I get that, and what I want to see is kind of the Jedi versus the Senate.
Yeah,
in the same way, the New Republic, in the same way of the Jedi or the old. However, I kind of don't want that because that's such an easy trope. The old ways are old and we're starting new.
First of all, Star Wars is all about tropes to the max and making them cool. And but think about, just imagine a movie where it's basically the New Republic forms and it's exactly like the Old Republic and the Jedi Temple is just back. Like, that's boring. Then you're just back at the prequel, and they're going to be fighting another Trade Federation if that happens. Like, just to have the Jedi just be back as the good guys, and the lead good guys all at once, is not only would make a boring movie, but it wouldn't make any sense for the story for them to just be like, hey, we're back, and everything is exactly how it was before the Empire.
I agree. No.
It's bad drama and it's nonsensical storytelling.
Honestly, I honestly want my almost dream Star Wars is the Jedi are not the main characters.
Really?
And it's not necessarily about politics, but it's called Star Wars. That's one of the reasons I like Clone Wars so much, is because they do a really good job with not making it all about the Jedi and Anakin Skywalker.
Well, let me tell you why it is going to be, though, and why it has to be, because you have, if you look at this...
Because that's what the franchise
The trilogy,
is.
Yes, first of all, yeah. But if you look at the now trilogy of trilogies, as you've got Act 1, 2, and 3 in each one... But, and also, those are Act 1, 2, and 3 of their own drama. And it's kind of like this rise and fall. So it's kind of like Darth Vader rises, falls, is redeemed, and then there's but then that's only halfway, so now it's going to be, in and of itself, this arc. So it's going to be three-generational Jedi story. Not necessarily Luke Skywalker's kid, but the next step in it'll be three movies of getting back to the Jedi being three stories that get the Jedi back to where they were.
Yeah, okay, I like
it's
that.
It's about
yeah,
the
yeah.
fall and
it's about
resurrection.
It's about the resurrection of the Jedi.
Of the Jedi Temple.
No, totally. Totally.
Yeah.
And that's all Luke Skywalker, so hopefully we'll see Luke Skywalker. That's all him. He rebuilds the Jedi Temple on Yavin 4.
Mm-hmm. Let's see in the comments.
I'm
I'm gonna start back here. I'm gonna do it on Sam's computer. We're gonna talk about. So much lens flare, no return of the fuck. Ollie, ain't a final chapter. Star Wars, the dick strikes back. A new dick, the dick wars. The phantom dick, the dick menace. I like mine better, the dick of the Sith. That's good, you've got Revenge of the Dick. Thanks, Revenge of the Dick, I guess you didn't, haha. The dick strikes back, the Empire strikes dick. You got that one, the fucking Return of the Cock. I'll go back. Okay, that's cool. It's oh, you're writing more shit here. The two cocks. More cocks. Come on, guys. Faster, 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 faster. Shite. Yep. Wait, listen. Faster, faster. Come on, more gibberish. You can do it. And faster and faster and faster and faster and faster. Faster, 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 faster. Sorry, I got booted for typing too fast. Sorry, I didn't know that could happen. Sorry, I fucked it up. But type faster and faster and faster. Faster and faster and faster. So now I'm watching the stupid ad again. So jealous. So jealous. Faster, faster, faster. Faster. But Monday's 9. That was weird. Thank you so much for watching and for talking to us. And for listening to us, and for being great listeners and great conversationalists.
You are great listeners.
And we really, this
really,
is
really, this show is about you guys. This, good on you guys. This show is, you're the real host of this show.
I was going to say the show was like a therapy session for me and Sam, and you guys are psychologists.
That's also true. If you notice, we just had a random guest, yeah. Actual user there for a second.
Really?
Who signed on for about 5 seconds, and then... Quickly, I'm sure, either shut their computer or blew their brains out.
Or their computer just exploded. I'm going with the fact that we broke their internet.
Okay, good night, everybody. We'll talk to you next week. If you don't show up next week, I'm going to come to your house and lick your nose while you sleep.
Put it, his tongue up it.
I'm going to put my tongue up your nose.